Hello and welcome back. In the previous tutorial segment, we created a couple of tables for simulating the partner management system using SQL Developer. It seems I forgot a couple of steps, so for example, let's add those a few additions. I should have made a kind of a foreign key relationship between this contract and vendor, so let's add it now. So let's add a kind of a foreign key from this contract back to vendor, so let's see that. We're referring to vendor table. And that's it. Okay. And while we are here, we can also add a primary key and say that this contract number is the primary key for this contract table. All right, so that takes care of that one. And our plan is to not really wrap these external tables which we created, vendor and contract, behind the web service interface, but to directly interface with them from this composite service. So we are ready to go, and that's done as we learned in the first tutorial series by dragging and dropping a database adapter here. Let's give this some meaningful service name, like let's press next. I have created a database connection already. But if you didn't follow the first tutorial set, you may have to create a new database connection. So let's create a new connection just to show how it goes. So username, password. And now we are ready to test. And that's fine. So this is how you would create a new database connection. Next, the kind of a key part is this JNDI name. And if you don't know what to put there, it's fairly easy to discover it. Let's go back to WebLogic server, because that's where the database resources are defined. Deployments. And under this database adapter, configuration, outbound connection function. Here we have the name of the JNDI name we need to be using. So let's copy that one over to here. This connection here, which we just created, is used for iteratively discovering what are tables in the database, and then we can, based on those tables, we can then construct the right SQL select statement. We'll be making a select statement again. We need to import tables. We need to iteratively discover what are the tables that we want to join in this case. So it will be contract and vendor. Okay. And the primary key will be contract. So we will be constructing a select statement where we give the select statement the contract number, because it will be one of the fields in this incoming invoice. And based on that one, it fetches all the relevant fields from this contract and vendor tables. So we'll be selecting this one-to-one relationship between contract and vendor. So every contract is associated with exactly one vendor. But a vendor can have multiple contracts under itself. So we'll be using all the fields. Let's just say that we take all the fields. Let's define a parameter criteria. Let's call this, for example, contract num. And then we'll edit the select statement. We'll add. selected is the parameter we'll be using. Contract number equals contract num, so that should be okay. Let's check. Alright, it should be okay. Next, next, and finish. And finally, we are ready to wire this DeepL process to this newly created database query. And that's all there is. So now we have integrated with the newly created database tables. And we are ready to proceed further. But let's do that in the next segment. So thanks for watching and see you in the next tutorial.